Dobro večer, želim. U svojstvu direktorke festivala Dunavski dijalozi, želim vam dobrodošlicu na otvaranjima izložbi crnogorsko-srpskih umetničkih dijaloga, koje započinjemo izložbom Nenada Šoškića i Ivana Šuletića u likovnom salonu Kulturnog centra Novog Sada. Nastavljamo u galeriji Suluva izložbom Ivane Radovanović i Zvonimira Sandrača. Sada u malom likovnom salonu predstavljamo umetnike Veska Gagovića i Milana Jakšića i u galeriji Belat, to je izložba Adina Rastodera i Milana Blanche.
Good evening. As a director of the festival Danube Dialogues 2017, I wish to welcome you at the opening of the exhibitions within the Montenegrin-Serbian Art Dialogues, starting with the exhibition of Nenad Šoškić and Ivan Šuletić at the Gallery of the Novi Sad Cultural Center, and continuing with the exhibitions of Ivana Radovanović and Zvonimir Sandrač at the Gallery of the Vojvodina Artists Association, Vesko Gagović and Milan Jakšić at the Little Art Parlor, and Adina Rastoder and Milan Blanuša at the Bell Art Gallery.
Sa posebnim poštovanjem pozdravljam ambasadora Republike Crne Gore u Srbiji, njegovu ekscelenciju Branislava Mićunovića, koji će ove naše večerašnje crnogorsko-srpske umetničke dijaloge otvoriti, i direktora Kulturnog centra Novog Sada, gospodina Bojana Ponotovića, koji je večeras naš domaćin.
With special respect, I welcome His Excellency Branislav Mićunović, Ambassador of the Republic of Montenegro to Serbia, who will open our Serbian-Montenegrin dialogues this evening, and Mr. Bojan Paneotović, Director of the Novi Sad Cultural Center, our host today.
Gospodine Paneotović, izvolite.
Mr. Paneotović, please take the floor.
Poštovani prijatelji umetnosti, Vaša ekscelencijo, poštovana Vesna, uvaženi slikari, uvaženi ljudi dobre volje, zaoštrava se vreme u kome postoje dva puta. Jedan je put dijaloga, ovaj na kome insistira Vesna Latinović, put prožimanja kultura, interkulturalnosti, normalnosti, suživota, i drugi je put jednoumlja, totalitarizma, egoizma i destrukcije svake vrste. Umetnici, ljudi od pera, od kičice, od pisane reči, od muzike, su uvek na sunčanoj strani ulice, kako reče onaj balkanski pesnik. Mi smo u minuloj godini imali reafirmaciju saradnje kulturnih centara Podgorice i Novog Sada, upravo u ovoj zgradi. Imali smo izvanrednu konferenciju o regionalnoj stabilnosti pre nekoliko meseci, takođe na tribini Mladih kulturnog centra Novog Sada, čiji su odjeci širom Balkana bili izuzetni. I današnji srpsko-crnogorski ili crnogorsko-srpski dijalozi samo su kontinuitet odlične saradnje na polju kulture između Srbije i Crne Gore, između Novog Sada i Podgorice, i sagledavajte to kako god želite. I ja ću reći još nešto i u prisustvu gospodina Mićunovića i gospođe Vesne Latinović i svih vas, pa šta košta da košta, ima kako ko shvatio, ko je bliži Crnogorcima nego Srbi i obrnuto. Ako mi neko preciznije to, ako to neko povrgne ili podastre neke argumente protiv toga, evo vam večeras i moje ostavke. Ali ubeđen sam da kvalitetnih argumenata protiv toga nema. A ako je to tako, a mislim da jeste, onda nema preče stvari od ovakvih dijaloga. Međutim, možemo mi debatovati i vršiti dijalog 10 dana i 10 noći ovde, uz prijatelje umetnosti. Ja moram da istaknem još jednu stvar. Ja bih mnogo više voleo u srpskoj štampi da čitam o barskom ljetopisu, o Budvi grad teatru, a mnogo manje da čitam koja starleta je na Miločeru, koliko puta i koji kupaći kostim presvukla. Da to ne kreira naše javno mnjenje, kad kažem naše, mislim i na Srbiju i na Crnu Goru, već da naše javno mnjenje kreiraju oni koji izvode predstave, koncerte, recimo u Budvi u toku leta. Voleo bih da u crnogorskoj štampi, u crnogorskim medijima pročitam prikaz neke predstave sa Bitefa ili neku kritiku kusturičnog ostvarenja ili šta god bilo, nekog romana naših pisaca koji imaju odlične rezultate širom sveta, ali se o tome mnogo manje piše nego ovim obskurnim stvarima koje pomenuh malo čas. Dakle, da srpsko-crnogorskim dijalozima, da diplomatskoj saradnji, da približavanju, ali na pravim, autentičnim, kulturnim, umetničkim vrednostima i temeljima, a ne na onome što, poput korova u bašti, sve više naše javno mnjenje prožima. Svako dobro i želim vam da u narednih nedelju, dve dana uživate u autentičnim kulturnim ostvarenjima. Hvala.
I'll do my best. Dear friends of art, Your Excellency, Honorable Vesna, dear artists, people of goodwill, at the moment there are two roads of our times that we may follow, that we may pursue. One of these roads is the road of dialogue, the one that Vesna Latinovic supports and promotes. It's the road of cooperation, the road of interculturality, the road of coexistence. The second road is the road of selfishness, single-mindedness, totalitarianism, egoism, and destruction on many levels, very many levels. However, artists, playwrights, writers, composers, people who are involved in any form of art are, as I would say, on the sunny side of the street. Last year, we reaffirmed cultural cooperation between Novi Sad and Podgorica. We also organized here at the Youth Tribune at the Novi Sad Cultural Center. We organized a conference devoted to regional stability, which had, which was met with very positive outlook all over the Balkans. And I would, in that spirit and on that note, like to welcome today the dialogue of Serbia and Montenegro, or Montenegro and Serbia, confirming that we are involved in an active and fruitful cultural cooperation. It also shows that there is a very long-standing tradition of cooperation between Montenegro and Serbia, between Podgorica and Novi Sad. I am not sure how you will interpret what I'm going to say next, and I will say it whatever the cost. Who is closer to us than the Montenegrins? And if any of the present people can have any valid arguments to the contrary, I can even vouch my resignation. And I'm sure that there are no arguments of this kind whatsoever. So nothing is more important than a dialogue. We can debate for 10 days and nights. I must add another thing. I wish our media, our press, and other media forms will focus on a greater quality of cooperation than what I can read in newspaper. I would certainly prefer to read about some great play or cultural event in Budva grad, then to read about what kind of bathing suit a certain starlet is wearing. And I think that the public opinion should be shaped more by artists and less by news of this kind. It would be much better if we could read some in the media about the criticism of the most recent work of art by Kusturica, maybe some review of a very good play, of a book. We do have excellent book authors and books, but our paper don't write much about this. And I will end by saying a big yes to Montenegro in Serbia dialogue, a big yes to diplomatic cooperation, and to closeness based on art, and not as, as we can say, weeds in the garden. All the best, and you can spend next week or two enjoying some real quality works of art.
Bravo. Hvala našem izuzetnom prevodiocu Jeleni Rebić. Kustos ove izložbe, ali i čitavog koncepta umetničkih dijaloga koji smo uveli od prvog izdanja Dunavskih dijaloga 2012. godine je Sava Stepanov, ujedno i umetnički direktor.
The curator of this exhibition and the whole concept of artistic dialogue, who has been with us since 2012, is Sava Stepanov, art director of the festival.
Izložbu postavka radova Nenada Šoškića, umetnika iz Podgorice, i Ivana Šuletića, slikara iz Beograda, zasnovana je na učinu slično strukturiranim, organizovanim vizualnim stanjima njihovih ostvarenja. U toj fasadnoj sličnosti postoje dve jasno definisane sadržinske, plastičke i značenske filozofije. Oblikovanom ili slikanom strukturom Šoškić i Šuletić objavljuju odlučno personalizovane iskaze. Šoškićevo delo struktura izgledom je blisko konstituciji slike. Ipak ovde nema ni jednog istinskog elementa slikarstva. Delo ne nastaje činom slikanja, nego je Šoškićev rad usmeren ka izgradnji bogate strukture materijala izdvojene iz svakodnevne upotrebe. Njegova instalacija je ostvarena od sedimentirane novinske hartije. U strukturi njegovog rada sabrane su i sadevene brojne informacije, vesti i fotografski prikazi aktuelnih zbivanja. Uz to, koristići se digitalnom tehnologijom, Šoškić nam predočava statistički podatak o količini dobrih i lepih pojmova kao što su ljubav, sreća, umetnost, dobrota i drugi, a koji su upotrebljeni u novinskom izdanju Podgoričke pobede. Podaci su poražavajući jer pokazuju odsustvo empatije, estetike, duhovnosti i ljudskosti. Sve to ukazuje da je Šoškić, polazeći od svakodnevne stvarnosti, uspeo da ostvari autentično estetsko delo nabijeno etičkim vrednotama, delo u kojem su sadržane neke od bitnih karakteristika našeg svakodnevlja i doba u kome živimo.
The display of artwork of Nenad Šoškić, artist from Podgorica, and Ivan Šuletić, painter from Belgrade, is based on observed similarities structured and organized into visual states of their creations. In this apparently similar, in this apparent similarity, there are two clearly defined philosophies. It's contact, content, plastics, and meaningfulness. Through their work and their painting structure, Šoškić and Šuletić decide to declare their strong personal commitments and statements. Šoškić's artwork is similar in its constitution to painting, to picture. Yet, there are no true elements of painting in it. The work of art, does not come into existence by the act of painting alone. Šoškić's work aims at rich structure made of sedimented newspaper. His installation is made of newspaper sediments, of material in everyday use. His work contains numerous information, news and photos of current events. Using digital technology, he gives us information and data about notions which are good and nice, for example, love, happiness, art, goodness, etc., used in Pobeda daily newspaper from Podgorica. These data are really devastating effect, showing the lack of empathy, of ethics, of spirituality, of basic humanity. This tells us that Šoškić, from proceeding from daily reality, managed to create authentic aesthetic work charged with ethical values, containing some of the important features of our daily life and times.
Kratko, beogradskog umetnika Ivana Šuletića mogu će razmatrati uz pomoć metode estetičara Etijena Surioa, koji je pisao da dobra slika posjeduje tri jasno vidljiva sloja, sloj sadržaja, sloj plastičkih elemenata i sloj filozofskog naboja. U sadržinskom smislu Šuletić je posvećen temi grada, urbanih prostora i arhitekture. U njegovim slikama skoro minijaturnih dimenzija on prikazuje motive gradskog ambijenta, pojedine zgrada, prometnica, fragmente susjednih građevina. Plastički sloj naslikanog motiva zasnovan je na sigurnom crtežu, na racionalno definisanim odnosima unutar pojedinačne slike, na diskretnoj obojenosti koja tvori specifičnu atmosferu. No Šuletić tako naslikane motive multiplicira. Precizno ih slaže jedan od drugog, struktura ih na platnima monumentalnih dimenzija. Stvara se precizan raster, jedinstven prizor ponavljajućih istovetnih sličica, kojim se celokupna površina slike pretvara u bogatu pikturalnu strukturu. Taka slika više nije funkcionalna, ona je kontekstualni proizvod. Ona nam ne prikazuje svet u kome živimo, nego nam govori o njegovom karakteru, o onim njegovim osobinostima koji su proizvod ikonosfere u kojoj svakog trenutka, zahvaljujući umnoženim digitalno-elektronskoj tehnologiji, slike postaju neraskidivi deo naše psihološke konstitucije.
The painting of Belgrade artist Ivan Šuletić can be analyzed by using the method of an aesthetician, Etienne Surioa, who wrote that a good painting contains three clearly visible layers, that of content, that of plastic elements, and of philosophic charge. In terms of content, Šuletić is devoted to the topic of city, to urban space, to architecture. In his paintings, of almost miniature dimensions, he shows city motifs, buildings, communication lines, fragments of buildings close by. The plastic layer of the painted motif is based on a definite, well-defined drawing on rationally defined relations within individual paintings, on discrete coloring which creates specific atmosphere. Šuletić multiplies thus created motifs. He adds them next to each other with great precision. He structures them on canvases of monumental dimensions. He creates precise density, unique scenes by repeating the same little images which create the whole surface of the canvas into a rich pictorial structure. Such a picture is not functional anymore. It becomes a contextual product. It shows us the world in which we live. It does not show us the world in which we live, but talks about its character, about those of its features which are the product of iconosphere, in which every moment, due to multiplied digital electronic technology, the images become an alienable part of our psychological constitution.
bih želeo da kažem da ovom izložbom zapravo otvaramo seriju izložbi posvećenu srpsko-crnogorskim dijalozima i ovde na ovom izložbu se zapravo najavljuje koncept tih dijaloga. Ovde su u svakoj galeriji su po dva umetnika koji su odabrani po sličnosti ili po različitostima, koje složene u jednoj izložbi daju jednu zajedničku poruku koja može biti različito filozofski organizovana. Tako da mislim da će ova izložba i naravno tri izložbe biti veoma zanimljive za dalje gledanje i za celokupnu koncepciju kojom se mi bavimo.
At the end, I would just like to add that through this exhibition, we in fact opened a series of exhibitions devoted to the Serbian and Montenegrin dialogue. Through this opening, we also announced the basic concept of the dialogues. What we have tried to do is take two artists, which we selected due to their similarities as well as to their differences, and we juxtapose them in one single exhibition, which will prompt us to reflect on their message and show that they give one message after all. So I think that this exhibition, as well as the next three ones which we have staged, will be very interesting for you to see and will amply illustrate the concept that we have proceeded from.
Zahvaljujem se gospodinu Savu Stepanovu. Večeras imamo zaista vrlo posebno zadovoljstvo i izuzetnu priliku da izložbu ili izložbe crnogorsko-srpskih dijaloga otvori njegov ekscelencija Branislav Bićunović. Ekscelencija, izvolite.
Tonight we also have a great pleasure and honor to have with us His Excellency Branislav Mićunović, Ambassador of Montenegro to Serbia, who will open this exhibition.
Dragi prijatelji, poštovana Vesna Latinović, poštovani gospodine Panopoviću, gospodine Stepanov, poštovani dragi konzule, Kankaraš, generalni konzul Crne Gore, Vojvodina, okružen prijateljima i na najljepši način zarobljen ovom krasnom idejom koju su gospodin Stepanov i njegovi saradnici, odnosno i Vesna i gospodin Panautović, smislili ovoga puta. Ja sam u posljednjih dvije godine postao fan ovog festivala. Prošle godine sam bio obećao da ću doći, da ću učestvovati u nekim panelima, bio sam na nekom putu i sve od prošle godine do danas nekako me to učinilo mi se kao da nešto dobro sam uradio i kao da sam nekog za nešto, ne daj Bože, prevario. Evo sad sam s velikim zadovoljstvom tu i kao prije svega kao ambasador Crne Gore u Republici Srbiji i kao čovjek koji je dosta dobar dio svog života radeći u Srpskom narodnom pozorištu, Mađarskom pozorištu, tako da je proveo u Novom Sadu gdje imam brojne prijatelje i prije svega najveći broj onih koji su umjetnici, koji su glumci, koji su reditelji, koji su slikari, koji su vajari i to je prije svega moj novosadski svijet. Ovu krasnu ideju zajedno sa vama, srpsko-crnogorske ili kako kažete crnogorsko-srpske dijaloge, zalažem zajedno sa vama za svaku vrstu dijaloga između Crne Gore i Srbije. Dijalozi su brojnim, brojnim ravnima života. Dijalozi su u ekonomiji, dijalozi su u nacijama, dijalozi su u politikama različitih oblika, ali dijalozi su i u duhovnosti i u umjetnosti. Imao sam sreću da budem prisutan na otvaranju novog izdanja divnog grčkog muzeja Akropolis i u to vrijeme predsjednik Evropske unije, Evropske komisije, Barroso, otvorio je taj muzej i izgovorio rečenicu da je umjetnost iznad ekonomije. Ja sam posle toga razgovarao s njim i on mi je poklonio taj njegov tekst, tom njegovom tezom koju i danas čuvam. Zalažemo cijel ovaj festival. Našem ukupno i u regionu i načelno vezama među ljudima. Ništa nije tako misionarski važno u vezi među ljudima kao što je art. Makar mislim da ne preterujem, pošto sam iz svijeta umjetnosti. Ali ja sam ovdje prije svega večeras kao ambasador Crne Gore u Republici Srbiji sa visokom čašću da otvorim ovu izložbu. I na tome sam vam zahvalan. Ovu izložbu doživljavam kao jedan vrlo simboličan, ali ne simboličan u smislu simboličan, samo simboličan, nego kao organski gest. I zato sam vas, gospodine Panautoviću, s pažnjom slušao vaš nadahnuti govor večeras bio je jedna, u najboljem smislu te riječi, inspiracija i lekcija i ja, ne namećući nikakvu svoju ideju za vaš rad i vaš koncept za iduću godinu, neću odoljeti da vam ne predložim, a moj drug Egon Savin kaže ja ću ti nešto reći, a ti me nemoj poslušati, da ovu temu stavimo iduće godine na dnevni red. Ona, upravo ovu koju ste vi tako čisto i jasno večeras izgovorili i uokvirili. Ja stojim ispred mog druga, mog prijatelja Nenada Šoškića. Ja sam njegov fan i veoma cijenim to što on radi, što radi kao vajar, kao čovjek i kao moj prijatelj. Izgovorit ću imena svih umjetnika koji večeras na svojim leđima nose ovu ne tako laku ideju. To je Nenad Šoškić, to je Vesko Gagović, to je Ivana Radovanović, to je Adin Rastoder, to je Milan Blanuša, Zvonimir Santrač, Milan Jakšić, Ivan Šuletić. Ko išta zna o likovnoj umjetnosti u Crnoj Gori, u Srbiji, zna ko su ovi ljudi. I zato je moja velika čast večeras, osjećanje visoke časti. I zahvaljujem vam još jedan put i festivalu i kulturnom centru Novog Sada i ovima 8 umjetnika da ste mi napravili zadovoljstvo i da u ime Crne Gore jednako sa osjećanjem da ovo činim u mojoj i našoj crnoj prijateljskoj Srbiji ovu izložbu proglasim otvoreno. Ja, zahvaljujem.
Dear friends, distinguished hosts, Vesna Latinović, Mr. Panautović, Mr. Stepanov, also General Consul to Montenegro here in Novi Sad. I'm here surrounded by friends and captivated by this great idea that Mr. Stepanov, Mrs. Latinović and Mr. Panautović came up with. I became a fan of this festival some time ago, and especially in the past 2 years. Last year I promised that I will take part as a participant in one of its panels, but I had to go on a trip, and I really felt bad about not being able to attend. I felt as if I betrayed someone, as if I cheated on someone. So it is my great pleasure today to be here with you as the ambassador of Montenegro to Serbia, and also as a man who lived here, who worked in the at the Serbia National Theater, Hungarian Theater in Novi Sad, and who spent here a lot of time, who's made very many friends, people, artists, actors, painters, sculptors, and so on. I feel that this idea of the dialogues between Serbia and Montenegro, or Montenegro and Serbia, as you say, is something we should all pursue, and I will support and advocate all forms of dialogue between Serbia and Montenegro. Dialogues are all around us. They are everywhere in the economy, in politics, but also in reality, and it's they are also in spirituality and in art. During the opening of the new edition of Acropolis in Greece, which I attended, I could hear the president of the European Commission, Mr. Barroso, say that art is above economy. And this was a very interesting thought, and later on, when we talked about it, he gave me the text with this thesis, and I've kept it ever since. This is a very important festival for the whole region, bringing people together. It is very important to build connections, and I firmly believe that nothing is as important to building connections as art. And I'm here as the ambassador with the great honor to open this exhibition. I thank you for the invitation, and I see this exhibition not only as a symbolic, but as a kind of organic gesture. Mr. Panayotovic, I listened very carefully to your inspired address, which was not only an inspiration, but also a lesson to all of us, and I do not want to impose on your agenda anything for the future, but I will propose that we put this forward as a topic for the next year. All these ideas that you so sincerely and clearly stated before all of us. So I stand here today before my friend Nenad Šoškić. I appreciate his work. I hold him in very high regard, both as an artist, but also as my friend. And I will mention the names of all the artists who are here with us tonight. So it's Ivan Radovanović, Zvonimir Santrač, Nenad Šoškić, Ivan Suletić, Vesko Gabović, Milan Jakšić, Adina Ristoder, and Milan Blanuša. I think I would like to thank them, as well as the festival, Danube Dialogues, and as well as Novi Sad Cultural Center. So all people here, and to thank you for giving me the pleasure to, on behalf of Montenegro, and me personally, declare this exhibition open. Thank you.
Ja ipak mislim da je to nije puka i slučajno.